Welcome back to English class. I hope you all are doing good. So today we are going to continue echoes, okay? We are going to learn lesson 4 from your echoes book. In the last class we studied lesson 3. So what's the title of lesson 3? Talking and asking about past ability, okay? Today we are going to learn about talking about people. So talking about people, in the sense, we can talk about our parents, we can talk about our friends, our neighbors, okay? So we can talk about so many people, okay? How we will talk, okay? That's what today we are going to learn through this lesson. If you are ready, let's get started. I want all of you to take your echoes book, okay? And turn page number 31. First, listen to this. Listen and learn. Listen to your few children about people they like most. So here we have three children, okay? They talked about the people that they like most. Let's see who are they, okay? So the first one is Shanti. Hello, I'm Shanti. This is my brother. They are talking about the other people through the picture, okay? So the first one is Shanti. Shanti is going to talk about her brother. Hello, I'm Shanti. This is my brother Anup. Anup is 12 years old. That makes him 4 years older than me. Anup loves playing cricket. He also loves watching cartoons and movies. His favorite character is Kung Fu Panda. Anup often helps me with my work. So here Shanti talks about her brother, about his age and what he likes, okay? So he loves playing cricket, he loves watching cartoon and movies, and also his favorite character, and okay, his attitude. So he used to help her with Shanti's work too, okay? So that's what Shanti talked about her brother. Now come to the second one, Ranjan, okay? Next one is Ranjan. Ranjan is going to talk about his aunt Shobha, okay? Let's see. Hi, my name is Ranjan. I'm going to tell you about my aunt Shobha. Aunt Shobha is my mother's younger sister. She is about 35 years old. She loves painting pictures. I think her favorite color is blue because all her paintings have the blue sky. This is one of her paintings, okay? Here Ranjan talked about her aunt Shobha, and who is Shobha, what is her age, and her likes, okay? So whenever we talk about other people, we used to talk about their age, their profession, their, okay, what they are doing, who are they, and what they like, what they don't like, okay? So these things we used to talk about other people. That's what here we learned in from the first two topic, okay? So there also Shanti talked about her brother, and she also said what he likes. Here Ranjan also said about his aunt. He also said what all the things that his aunt likes, okay? Now come to the next one, Farah is going to talk about her grandfather, okay? Hi, I'm Farah. This is my grandfather, Dr. Arshad Ahmed. Grandpa is about 70 years old, but he is still quite active. He reads poems in English and Urdu. His favorite color is yellow. He loves eating chocolates, which he shares with me. Okay, here Farah talked about her grandfather, Dr. Arshad Ahmed, and he is 70 years old. Even though he is 70 years old, he is still doing good, okay? Because he is very active. He likes to read poems in English and Urdu. And she also said about his favorite color and what all the things he likes to eat, okay? So, come to the next one. See, take your pencil and underline this. To describe a person, we use the simple present tense, okay? While describing about other people, while talking about other people, we have to use simple present tense like is, has, have, likes, reads, eats, loves. Okay, these are the simple present tenses. You should not talk about, talk in the form of past tense. Okay, while you are talking about other people, you have to use simple present tense. Is, has, have, likes, reads, eats, loves, etc., etc. Now, while describing a person, we usually describe their age, underline, their likes, dislikes, favorite things and such like. Okay, so here we saw the above three people. While they talk about other people, they said their age and what they like. Okay, so if you are describing about other people, first we have to say their age, their likes, their dislikes, their favorite things, what they are doing. Okay, so and so. You can talk so many things like that. Okay, fine. Now come to the next page. So now I hope you all got an idea how to talk about other people, how to describe other people. Now I think we can skip page number 32 because it's listen and mark. And we can also skip the page number 33, listen and write. Just skip it. Now come to this. Listen and repeat. Stress only the words in bold. Okay, so some words are in bold. We have to stress only those words. Pick it up. Talk to her. Hasn't she? Have some more. Don't you? Bring it over. Put it on. Send it in. Give me some. Haven't you? She loves it. I know it. You like it. He told him. We want them. She's seen it. We have done it. I brought them. I hate it. He ate it. Are you hungry? Can you sing? Do you want? Can I sit? Is that Mira? Can we leave? Do I wait? Shall we go? Have you slept? Will he come? Okay. So the remaining words, we should not stress. Okay, only the bold words should be stressed. So try to read this, repeat, practice it again and again. Now come to page number 34. Here also same like that. See, in sentences, not all words are stressed. Auxiliary verbs and pronouns are generally non-stressed. Okay, auxiliary verbs and pronouns, we shouldn't stress those words. Okay, so see, we used to read like, what do you want? So, what do you want? Okay? We should not stress what do you want. We shouldn't read like that. It's like, what do you want? Okay? Now, where does she live? What do you mean? What do you say? Why do you leave? When will you come? Where will she go? What is she like? When did you leave? When can I come? Okay, we shouldn't stress when can I come. It's not like that. When can I come? When did he leave? What is she like? Where will she go? When will he come? Why do you leave? What did he say? What do you mean? Where does she live? What do you want? Okay, so practice like this. So if you practice again and again, okay, even you will talk like that. Okay, so just keep in your mind, auxiliary verbs and pronouns are generally not stressed. Okay, fine. Now the next one is listen and role play. Listen to the conversations first, then practice with a partner. They asked you to listen, but we can't listen. So just listen to me. I'm going to read both A and B for you. So at home, if you have brother or sister, or you can also practice this with your parents, with your mom or dad. Okay, so you have to act like A and the other person should act like B. Okay, and you have to do the role play. Now I'm going to read it for you, just listen. So at home you can practice it. Hello, are you in the colony? Yes, we moved in on Sunday. Hello once again, I'm David. Hello David, I'm Kirti. Tell me about your family, Kirti. Do you have a brother or sister? Yes, I have a sister. She's very young. She's only 4 years old. What does your father do? He works in a factory. He is an engineer. And your mother? She works in a bank. What does she like to do at home? She cooks for us. She loves watching TV when she is free. She loves the Discovery Channel. And your dad? What does he like to watch? He loves cricket. Okay, so this is number one. So the conversation is in between David and Kirti. Okay, so what David and Kirti talked about? They discussed about their family. Okay, what, whether they have brother or sister and what their father and mother are doing. Okay, and what they like, what they used to do at home. Okay, so they talked about these things. And now come to the second conversation. It's about Sheena and Lalita. Okay, let's see what's going on here. Hello Sheena, good to see you after many days. Hope you have settled down in your new city. Yes, I have. I also made many new friends. Why don't you tell me about them? Who is your best friend in Vijayawada? Lalita. How old is she? Is she in your class? Lalita is 9, 1 year older than me. She is not in my class, but we travel in the school bus together. Where does she live? She lives in my colony. That is how we became friends. What does Lalita like to do? She likes reading storybooks and watching cartoons. She draws quite well too. What's her favorite subject? English? No, it is science. She's quite good at it too. That's nice. I must be going. Bye, Sheena. Bye. So here, two friends talked about a new friend Lalita. Okay, so one is asking to Sheena about her new friend Lalita. So Sheena describes about Lalita, about her age, about her likes, about her dislikes. Okay, so that's it. And so this is what talking about people. Okay, almost we completed this lesson. I hope now you all understood how we have to talk about other people. Now come to page number 36. Here you have an activity. Okay, walk in pairs. Each one of you will pick a card from a set and ask answer questions about the topic mentioned in the roll call. See, we have two set of things. Look at the first one. Talk to your friend and find out the following about her best friend. So the first one is, you have to talk to your friend and you have to find out from her about her best friend. Okay, about your friend's best friend, about your friend's name, age, favorite food, favorite color, favorite TV channel. That's what you are going to ask to your friend, and you are going to do this as your activity. Okay, so the answer should be like this. Okay, here you have an example. Name, so your friend's name. Here they have given Asha as an example. Age, so your friend's age is 8 or 9 or 10, whatever it is, you have to mention the age. And favorite food, here fish. Okay, so your friend's best friend's favorite food. And favorite color, favorite TV channel. That's what you are going to mention it. Okay, it is going to be very easy. So I just want you to try this. Now the next one is, talk to your friend and find out the following about her cousin. Okay, so the first one is your friend's best friend, and here your friend's cousin. So your cousin's name, your cousin's age, where your cousin is live, the place, and the favorite color of your cousin, favorite TV channel of your cousin. So here the same goes here. We have an example. Name, age, place where she lives, favorite color, favorite TV channel. This is an example. So you are going to do this as an activity. Okay, so fine, that's all. I hope you all understood this topic, talking about people. So practice try to read it again and again, and practice the role play with your friends or with your brothers or sisters, okay? And yeah, that's all. So we can meet on the next class with a new topic. Until we meet again, take care. Bye bye. Thank you.